Yarana! Welcome back, everybody. Thank you for joining me once again. It is Thursday at 5 p.m. Eastern time. If you are catching this live, you know that. And if you're catching the recording, pretty much every Thursday, or I try to do every Thursday, once a week, do my Tahitian moment live. And so this week, I am very happy to have a brand new guest to the show, somebody who's never joined me before. And as you can see from the beautiful background here and the banner up top over there, today we're going to be talking all about the Hilton Hotel in Tahiti, which is the newest property in Tahiti. It's got a lot of history to it, and it has been fully redone. So we're going to learn all about that. But before we jump into that, just for those of you that don't know me, have never met me, have never joined me before, watching this live for the first time, my name is Carl. I own and operate Tahiti by Carl. I spend all day, every day doing nothing but planning dream vacations to Tahiti. So what I do is I work with travelers to take the complexity out of planning and booking customized, memorable Tahitian vacations. So I am here for you. If you are looking to go to Tahiti, please reach out to me and we can get the planning started. And I promise you, you won't be disappointed. As those of you know, during the show, I can see how many people are watching, but we have no idea who's watching. We love the interaction. So please drop a comment, say hello so I know that you're watching. But especially if you have questions about this hotel, I have the expert with me today. So please, 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 feel free to shoot any of your questions out and we can answer them today. And if we don't know the answer, then we, of course, will look into it and get back to you. But without further ado, let me bring on Jennifer from the Hilton Tahiti Hotels. Hello, Jennifer.
Your Honor.
Thank you so much for joining me. So this is the first time because I talked about your beautiful property once before with your colleague Natalie, and that was such a sneak preview before it was even opened. So I'm thrilled to have you here so we can talk about the lovely Hilton Tahiti.
Thank you. Yeah, we're very excited. We just opened November 15th of last year, so we've been open for 9 months now.
Yeah. Yeah. And I was there in November. When was I there? I was there in November. I was there like probably November 22nd or something or other. It was still classified the soft opening. And it was, it was so good to see that property, to see the brand new property. And I can't wait to be back again this November when I'll be staying for my second visit as well, which will be nice.
See all the changes a year later.
Exactly. And see how all the gardens and everything are starting to fill in. So that's always, I always love the lush greenery. And I find whenever properties are brand new, you see everything all planted, but then you go back 2, 3, 4 years later and it's all filled in and lush and so tropical. So
the plants grow very fast in Tahiti.
Yeah. And so darn beautiful too, right?
Yeah.
So we have a couple of hellos here coming in at us already. Hello, Larry.
Hi, Larry.
Larry's looking at heading down to Tahiti sometime soon when we sort out his dates. And same with Sandra, planning a big trip down there as well. Sandra, thanks for joining us. So it was interesting because before the show, you and I were talking, saying that we both stayed at this hotel. Well, for me, it was the first place I ever stayed in Tahiti.
It was for me as well.
For you as well. That's funny. And that was way back when it was called the Sheraton Tahiti, right?
So the resort, I believe the resort was closed for about 10 years. And then we completely renovated it. I mean, we just took it everything down to the studs. We added two new wings, enlarged the swimming pool. So we now have the largest swimming pool in Tahiti. So it's fresh, it's beautiful. And I just can't, I love talking about it.
It's world class, I always say. I say you could take that hotel and you can put it anywhere in the world, you know? It's
It's just a beautiful contemporary Tahitian feel.
Totally. Shall we bring on the presentation here?
Sure.
One second, let me make sure I'm opening up the right Oh, I think that. Oh, sorry, one second. I should have this down pat now after doing these for over a year, but there we go. Okay, actually, I'm just going to take the banner off the top too, just because it kind of blocks some of your beautiful slides. There we go.
All right. So this is our gorgeous lobby. So you get off the flight and you arrive and you walk in and you have this beautiful view of Moorea in the background, the ocean. And it's a gorgeous lobby. Over to the left, you see the wood carving and it's reminiscent of a Tahitian tattoo. Over on the right hand side is our lobby bar. This is a great place to go. Did you enjoy a cocktail on the
Of
terrace?
course.
So this terrace right outside is a great place to have a cocktail in the evening and enjoy the sunset.
Yeah, it's got such beautiful views from the terrace there.
And we also have coffee here and pastries throughout the day. I had somebody tell me that they have the best cappuccino they've ever had in their life at our little pastry bar in the lobby. So
If anybody's not familiar with French pastries, I was talking to a client who just came back and we were talking about the pastries throughout the whole island. You know, when you're buying a pastry in North America, there is zero comparison to what you will get in Tahiti because the French chefs and the French pastries, the quality of the croissants and the, you know, it's just mouth-wateringly good.
I also represent the Conrad Borbornui, and I call our pastry chef over there Evilicious.
Because they are amazing over there at
Her
the
pastries are the best I've ever had in my life.
Yes, they has got such a great breakfast buffet there. But we're going to bring you back another day to talk more about that.
You got me sidetracked with the pastries. Okay, so we have 200 beautiful rooms at this resort, and many of them are in the suite inventory, and three wonderful restaurants and two bars. And one of the restaurants is over the water, fine dining. And we were chatting earlier, we do have a small private dining room, which will accommodate up to 16 guests.
Which I think is fantastic for all the families that are going down. I mean, I just have a family going in November, and I'm thinking, well, this could be a perfect maybe for their last dinner there last night or something like that. So yeah, that's nice to have because we're getting more and more families in small groups going. It's not just for couples, you know, or couple, like you're getting friends traveling together too with, you know, two, three, four couples going down together as well.
Families haven't seen each other in a couple of years and they just want to go relax in paradise.
Why not, right? Why not?
So, the land that this hotel is built on has a lot of history. So, it is in the same location of the Hotel Tahiti, which was the very first hotel ever built in the islands in the 60s. Many famous guests came and stayed at the Hotel Tahiti, Marlon Brando, the Beatles, dignitaries. So when we opened the hotel, they wanted to honor the original property that sat there. And so we named it the Hilton Hotel Tahiti.
That's so nice. And I love that picture. So it's so historic in some ways, but if you flip that over to a color picture, that could be on, you know, that could be now too, right? Because when they do a Polynesian show, it's you know, that's the way they are. So
definitely.
Yeah.
So our location, we're in an excellent location. We're just 5 minutes from the airport. We're also just a few minutes to downtown Papeete and 7 minutes from the pier if somebody is taking a cruise. And I love, they just put in a pedestrian footpath so you can walk along the ocean to downtown Papeete if you choose to do so.
Yeah, that's fantastic. I mean, you have hands down the best location. Right? Like it's just so close to the airport, so close to downtown. The fact that you could walk downtown or a short cab ride if people aren't walkers, right? It's not far.
Right.
It's one island where you can get cabs. But also don't forget you're attached to the shopping mall too, right?
Right. Yeah. So I think the next slide shows a So here's kind of a map of the resort. Hmm. So right off of the lobby, we have a pedestrian footbridge. So clients can walk across the street to the mall that's over there. It's open 7 days a week. Most of Tahiti shuts down on Sundays, mm-hmm. but the mall is still open until 1 p.m. So you can go over there and buy a swimsuit. There's lots of restaurants. There's a pharmacy if you forgot anything, but there's a large French grocery store called a Carrefour. So you can pick anything up from a television to your souvenirs. I picked up Manoi oil. I shopped all over for a special t-shirt for my husband, and I actually found it over at Carrefour after running around downtown Papeete for an hour. And there's adult beverages and French cheeses. So you can pick those up and bring them back over to the resort, or if you're flying over, taking the ferry over to Moorea or flying over to Bora Bora, you can bring some snacks over with you as well.
Yeah, super convenient. And really, again, is the only place that has that sort of convenience. And there's a bank there too with the bank machine. So that's nice for people as well, because I always get my money from the bank machine when I arrive if I want French Pacific francs. So it's a nice convenient spot to do that as well.
Right.
Yeah. So the rooms, did you want to talk a little bit about
the
rooms?
Sure. Yeah, if you can go to the next slide.
Go to the next one, okay.
Sure. So these are our gorgeous rooms. They're contemporary Polynesian feel with a lot of Tahitian touches to them. So the bed, they're just beautiful. They're backlit, and that is reminiscent of a traveler's palm, which was very sacred to the Tahitians because it held water for them. And that the sofa there is a American sofa sleeper, so it does pull out. Then there's a nice little balcony. You can sit outside and enjoy a coffee. A desk for those of you that cannot give up work life. You can pull your laptop out and work there. Of course, we have coffee and tea makers. There's a refrigerator, so if you want to get a bottle of champagne across the street at Carrefour, you can bring it over there and keep it chilled. A safe to hold your valuables. And then if you'll show the next slide, please. These are the gorgeous bathrooms. So they're Italian marble with rainhead showers. And what you can't really see in this photo is, the tile's just beautiful. It reminds me of the inside of a shell. What did you think when you experienced that?
Gorgeous. Yeah, like everything was it's still so bright, but like you know, the wood, so it was very modern, but like you say, still Polynesian and Tahitian,
right.
All the accents. All
warm touches.
Yeah. Which I'll show the video, because I have a video when I was there in November. I did the stayed in the one bedroom ocean view suite, so we can show the video, because I made a video walking through the room. That might show the tiles. I don't know. I can't remember if it shows the tiles better or not. But yeah.
Yeah. So most of our inventory is in king bedded rooms. I can't remember if there's a picture. Okay, so we do have queen embedded rooms as well. And those are in the garden and ocean view categories. And as you can see, they're 452 square feet. So by industry standards, that's quite large for a hotel room. I think the next slide is, okay. So queen bedded rooms come with tubs. So, Carl, don't ask me if you can have a king bed with a tub. It will not happen. So all the queen bedded rooms have tubs. So if you really want a bathtub, you can do that. And then we have 22 connecting rooms. So the two queen's beds will connect to the king.
The king bed. So great for families.
Great for families.
There's a lot of connecting rooms too. It's, you know, sometimes we'll find hotels have them, but they're darn near impossible to get. So,
right.
So yeah. Yeah. So that's nice.
Well, Carl has connections to get you those connections. And we have 8 ocean view suites, and this is my favorite suite that we have. So this is this private sleeping area, and there's a large walk-in closet. If you show the next picture. And the reason why this is my favorite is because they're on the corner of the building. So you have views of Moorea on one side and then the harbor on the other side. So
this is the room I stayed in.
Is it?
So spacious. It was so, yeah, so nice. I didn't have long enough in there. I was only there for one night, but it really was a super, super comfortable.
Don't they have incredible views?
Yeah, the views are just amazing. And you're forever seeing, because the ferries run back and forth to Moorea, so you're ever seeing the boats. So every time you look out the window, there's always, you know, a little bit of action happening.
Right.
You've got the pier over there and the big yachts and the cruise ships. And so, yeah. No, it's,
yeah, and there's cool. A nice little table. These will accommodate four adults or 2 adults and 2 children. Yeah. So there's a little area to, eat if you want to have a little snack in the room. And that sofa does pull out into a sofa sleeper as well. And these are the gorgeous bathrooms. So they have large soaking tubs, and then a huge walk-in shower.
Yeah, with a huge rain head shower. Look at the side.
Right.
Which I love.
Yes, yes. Mm. And this is the bedroom in the premium suites. We have one garden view. The rest are all ocean view. So this is the living space. If you show the next slide, they have small kitchens. What you can't see is there's a full-size refrigerator to the left, and then there's a little wine refrigerator, microwave. So you can't prepare a full meal, but you can prepare snacks. And if you're traveling with kids or somebody that, you know, needs to heat something up, you can bring your leftovers up and heat those up. And then the living room area is on the other side.
And I think this is great. Like you say, for families, of course, because, you know, the kids want to wake up and just have their cereal for breakfast or something simple, or, you know, like snacks, like you say. But also one of the things that people, if anybody is a big hiker, you know, the Tahiti has so many hikes. I just see a room like this, you know, you come back from your hike and you can just have some cold beers in the fridge, sit on your, you know, sit on your balcony. And the carpool is right, like we were saying beforehand, like that's the best thing with this hotel, because other hotels that may have kitchenettes, if you don't have a car, you can't get to a grocery store to buy groceries. But here, you just walk across the bridge, buy whatever you like, and walk back again. So it's super, super convenient, right? So,
right.
Yeah. So for people, the hiker thing, I was thinking, like, because people might want to stay longer on the island of Tahiti. So it's a nice, you know, nice to have that added amenities for the.
Or you can work from one of these suites as well.
Yeah.
Everybody's working from home now. Come. True. Work from Tahiti.
Yeah.
So there's a large walk-in closet, of course. As you can see, we have a safe and bathrobes, ironing board.
Uh-huh.
And then the gorgeous bathroom. So this has, again, a large soaking tub, the huge shower with the rain head again, and the beautiful vanity. Mm. And then these are my favorite. We have 4 2-bedroom suites. So these are 1,238 square feet. We'll take a maximum of 5 guests. So 2 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, and if you show the next slide, a full kitchen. Right. So this is like an apartment.
I didn't get to see those when I was there, so I have to arrange to see them. Hopefully they aren't sold out when I'm down in November.
Well, good luck, because I've been there twice since we opened and I haven't been able to see one.
Or hopefully the person checks out and the next people are on the late night arrival coming in and I might be able to.
Right. And these are the gorgeous bathrooms. So there's 2 identical bathrooms in the 2-bedroom suite that look like this. And then we have the master suites. So these are in an ideal location. Both of them are in the front of the building. So they're overlooking the pool, overlooking Moorea. And this is the master in the suites. And then the next slide, these are the gorgeous living rooms. Were you able to see one of these?
No, I didn't see these either.
But. Yeah, hopefully next time you come, they'll be open for you to see. Yeah. Well, I prefer them sold out, but.
Yeah, I can just sneak in for, you know, I don't need long. I just need, or you can put me in one if you like.
Yeah, so these are gorgeous. And again, they're on the corner of the building. Mm-hmm. So they have the beautiful views of Moorea in the background and then the harbor on the side.
Nice.
And then the gorgeous bathrooms. So our restaurants, this is Moevai.
Before we jump into the restaurants, I'm just getting a bunch of comments in here. Let me just run through those first and then we'll hop into the restaurants now that we're done the rooms. And everybody at the end of this presentation, I'll play the video with the walkthrough of the one bedroom suite as well from when I was there. Michael, bonjour, Carl. Finished the second quarter French. Can't wait to use it and the SPF 50 at the same time. So Michael is leaving in. What is it, Michael? It's like, it's just a few weeks now. Like he's taking off soon. So he's got a beautiful trip planned. Wen, thanks for joining again. Feed me. That must have been when we were talking about the earlier food. So Wen, I hope you're still watching here as we move into the restaurant section of the, of the presentation. Melissa. Do you offer early check-in? I looked at the flights in both Air France and Air Tahiti New Zealand around 5 a.m. or 7 a.m. Yeah, you can do early check-in, right?
Yes.
Comes at a cost, of course.
It does come at a cost, yes.
Yeah. But early check-ins can definitely be arranged, and day rooms and late checkouts as well, which we'll touch on afterwards. And then one more from my faithful watcher here, Liz. Sorry, I'm late. No problem, Liz. You know where to catch the reruns if you miss the want to catch the first part. But thank you again for joining everybody, and it's so nice to see like some of these people, Jennifer, are with me like every single week. It's crazy.
They're gonna be Tahiti experts.
They are. Truly, they are for sure. So. Okay, let's move on to the restaurants and the food.
Okay, so this is Moevai. It's our over-the-water restaurant. And this is where you enjoy your breakfast buffet in the morning. And over to the left, you really can't see. You can see a little bit of it. We have a nice deck outside, and that's my favorite place to have breakfast in the morning. Right. But and then the evening, it transitions into a fine dining restaurant. What I really love about it is they have the lights shining up. And so you can see the fish swimming below the restaurant in the evening.
Yeah, that's great. Because the resort doesn't have a beach, just so everybody knows. It doesn't have a beach, but we're going to look at the pool in a minute because it's got the best pool. But the water is still spectacular. You know, it's just so clear, and the color and everything is still really, you know, really nice. Like you say, to be able to look right into the water and see the fish swimming around. So.
And then Taitea, it's our French brasserie. You can see it's located by the pool, so it has amazing views of the ocean as well. Mm-hmm. And I did have dinner here, and it was phenomenal.
And yeah, I did lunch. I did lunch there, and it was delicious as well. Yeah.
And then our Asian restaurant is opening later this year in the fall. But right now we are serving sushi in here. So we have a wide selection of sushi, and clients are really enjoying that option.
And you were telling me your chef is coming in right from Asia.
Yes, from Asia. So with the borders closed, Asia's really not letting anybody out of the country right now. So when things reopen, we will have our chef.
Yeah,
I know. And this restaurant will open.
That's great.
It's ready to go. We just need an amazing chef.
Yeah. No, I look forward to trying that once he's there. Yeah. So I love my Asian food.
So do I. And then our bars. We talked about our lobby bar. So great place to get a cocktail. It opens at 11 a.m. for anybody that wants to partake. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. So 11 a.m. and it stays open until after midnight. So if you choose to have an adult beverage late in the evening.
Coming in on that late night flight, right, you get to the hotel at 10:30, 11 o'clock.
Glass of champagne and celebrate your arrival in Tahiti. You can do that. Exactly. We also have light snacks here. So, you know, the guests are hungry after they arrive late at night. They can get something to eat if they'd like. But I say the heart of the hotel is our Vaipuna Pool Bar. Did you enjoy a cocktail down here?
I didn't have time to have a cocktail there, but I will in November, I promise you.
All right. So it is a swim-up pool bar. I think Carl's photo in his background may have a little bit. You can see the other way, Yeah, you can see the stools in your photo. So it's a swim-up pool bar. And then on the other side, there's seats, you know, in a dry area. Mm. There's sofas to sit. And I just love these tables that are set in the pool.
Yeah, it's a great place to have a
craft cocktail and a snack. It's got the beautiful views of the ocean. And we have live music here several nights a week. So it's just the heart of the hotel. The guests really love to come down by the pool bar and hang out. And as I mentioned before, we do have the largest pool in Tahiti. And I was telling Carl earlier, I was here on a trip and I ran into somebody that I knew and we went to take a picture in the pool and I touched the lounge chair and I didn't realize they moved around. So you can, you know, if you don't want the sun in your face, but you still want to sit in the pool, the chairs can be moved around, or you have a group of people together, or you want to have a conversation. So I really thought that was fun.
Yeah, they look so perfect in the picture. You'd think that they're
cemented
into the pool the way they're lined up there.
Right. And the last time I saw the resort, before February, it was a hard hat. So I've been looking at these pictures for the last, you know, 6 months. I had no idea the chairs moved.
Surprise.
Yeah. And then the cabanas. So the cabanas are for the hotel guests only, and they can be rented for a half a day or a full day if you just want to sit by the pool and relax. There's a safe in that cabinet as well as a refrigerator.
Yeah, they're really beautiful.
They really are.
Is there a limit of number of people that could use one or something like that, or it doesn't matter? They just rent it and.
Well, there's supposed to be, I'm going to have to check on that.
Let me check on that, Carl. I mean, a great way, like this, for my clients here, I mean, one of the options when you're finishing your trip in Bora Bora is, you know, your checkout time is always going to be like 11 o'clock, usually at most resorts. So you can check out of your room, but then you're a little bit homeless until the flight leaves around 6 p.m. to bring you back to Tahiti to fly back to California. So one of the options that I do with clients is we'll fly you back on an 11 o'clock flight, get you into Tahiti at 12 noon, transfer you to this beautiful hotel and do a day room here. And then you could get a cabana for the afternoon, you know, have something to eat in your cabana, have some cold drinks there, relax. Mm-hmm. Your room, shower, get refreshed. It's a really nice way to end a trip as well, you know. Perfect to begin, but it's a great way to end it too,
right? Yeah. And then we do have a 24-hour fitness center, and this picture doesn't do it justice. You saw it, the fitness center.
Yeah, I was shocked that it was so big.
and the one thing I love is it has views of the ocean. There's nothing I hate more than being in the dungeon of a hotel on my bike or the treadmill.
Yeah.
I like to see the ocean.
Yeah.
And we just opened our wellness center. We have three treatment rooms. So another option would be to fly over and get a massage before you get on the plane or facial. So we have different treatments available, and I will get Carl the link for the spa menu, so he will be able to share that yes. with his clients.
That is nice, you know, you have that massage and then you have a light, nice dinner and then transfer to the airport and you just, you know, it's important.
Right. And your trip.
People do these dream trips and then I see them like stuck and like some people will sit at an airport for 6 hours before they fly home. And, you know, you spent so much money on such a perfect trip. You know, let's end it. You know, I'm all about creating that experience from beginning to end. And end is ready to, you know, right before you fly out. So something like that is.
You're absolutely right. Because before the Hilton opened up, I had to stay at another property and we had to check out. And so I hired a cab to basically follow me around. And I went downtown and then I had lunch. And, you know, I felt homeless.
Yeah. Yeah. And there's nothing worse than that. You know,
and I didn't want to go sit at the airport for 5 hours. So.
Yeah. And because the airport does not offer much, right?
Right. So, yeah.
Yeah. No, so. You must, you know, for everybody going, we have to have a plan. I've got different things that we can do too. It's not a day room, but I mean, you have to have some sort of plan because it's a special trip. So you want it to be special to the end. And Sandra was just saying, we can add this into your itinerary, Sandra, finishing the trip in the cabana. So, so yeah, we can definitely. Yeah.
Don't forget that massage.
she put this comment before we talked about the massages. So change your mind on that one and switch it to a massage.
Yeah, our spa is beautiful. I mean, it looks like a resort spa. It's just, I need to get a photo of it. Hopefully.
Yeah, because I didn't get to see
get the either. Photographer over there and take some pictures soon.
Yeah, that's nice because. It's probably the best spa on the island of Tahiti, I would think, knowing from what I know. So, yeah. And day rooms.
Day rooms available. We've already talked about that. Yeah. So, so you can enjoy the facilities, have a place to take a shower before you go on your flight home, store your luggage, store your valuables in the safe, and you don't feel homeless.
Yeah. And it's important. I've done it. I've been down so many times. I've done it so many different ways, but I will always pay for a day room at the end now because I really enjoy that. Well, I mean, for me, I know people on the island, it's easy to say goodbye to them too before you leave, but it's just a nice way just to reorganize the suitcase a little bit, just to have a shower, go to the airport feeling fresh. It makes a world of difference. And your day rooms are great because the time's available too, right? We've got two different rates.
Right.
You can check in as early as 6 a.m. until 10 p.m. on a day room, or we can do 12 noon until 10 p.m. on a day room for a lower price. And it's, you know, that's really good because some of the resorts are 11 a.m. check-in. Some of the resorts are 3 p.m. check-in for day rooms. So with, you know, 3 p.m. is not always so helpful, right? Especially if you're getting off like the Paul Gauguin cruise and you get off the ship at 8 in the morning, you don't want a 3 p.m. Yeah. A 3 p.m. check-in, that's no good. So, yeah. Sorry, I'm just trying to see here. I've got another comment here. sorry. You can the cabana and the massage. Yes, your trip to Tahiti is all about spoiling and pampering yourself. Kevin, you're supposed to be banned from my YouTube presentations. Kevin keeps on watching every week and now he wants to change his trip every time he watches another. we can definitely add that at the end of your trip, Kevin, for sure. I'll have to pull up that itinerary and let's not forget. So we can certainly add that in if you like. Very good. Yes. And so then that's the beautiful front of entryway into the hotel, right?
Yeah, beautiful. You pull in through the porte cochere and then you walk in and you have that beautiful view of Moorea in the background.
Yeah, it's nice. So maybe I'll show now this for everybody that's watching this. It's about it's closer to 4 minutes long. But this will give you a really good idea as well. You've seen all the pictures of the rooms, but this was the room that I had. It's the one bedroom ocean view suite. Suite number 317 when I stayed there in November, and this video is actually posted on my YouTube channel, but I think we've got time. Yeah, we got time.
And now they're going to ask for 317, Paul or Carl.
Well, I'll email you and we'll request it. Requests are never guaranteed, but we'll do our best, right? Okay, so I'm going to put this on. If you want, Jennifer, you should be able to mute your mic, but otherwise, everything you say, we can still hear while the video plays. So if you want to comment over top of it as well, you can always do that. But I talked through the whole thing too. But let's pop this up here for everybody to see. Welcome to the Hilton Tahiti. I'm going to take you on a walk through of my room here. This brand new hotel, just in the soft opening. And this is one of the lovely one bedroom ocean view suites. So you come in the door and to the left, there's a fabulous, sorry, I just arrived. I don't know where the light switch is. There we go. Fabulous bathroom with the double sinks. Nice large walk-in shower. It's very modern, contemporary, but still with a lot of wood accents to give you the, the Polynesian feel. Beautiful soaker tub here. I just love the little fish. Just a little bit of fun there. So then they've got the area here where you can store your luggage and then walk you on through here. And this is into the master bedroom. So you've got a big TV here on the right that is reflecting from outside, but the king size bed, beautiful closets over here with the robes and everything in there for you. And then walk you around here. You've got lots of balcony space. The balconies aren't large, but this property is a very old property that they've redone. But you can see here the balconies are very nice with a couple of sling chairs there, so very comfy. Beautiful views from my room here that look out. You got Moorea off in the distance. You have the overwater restaurant, which is where you have your breakfast, and it's also a dinner option as well. You can look out here. There's a ferry there coming across. And let me just take you in. So that's one balcony area. I'll take you over here into the living area. So this place is very big, very spacious, super comfortable here. So here we've got another TV up here, and then around you've got the couch with this tropical wallpaper I just love. So again, modern, contemporary, but then still with the Polynesian and the tropical touches. And then we've got here the coffee bar area. You've got a table here if you want to do room service and order in, if you were sitting to do any work. Once again, this particular room looks out this way. I've got the views of the port, so I can see the Aranui cruise off in the distance. There's the Taravao ferry heading out. There is a big yacht there that I was just told is Mark Zuckerberg's yacht docked in there. That was Paris Hilton was on that for her honeymoon while I was here. Yeah, and then walking around. So these doors open up as well for the breeze and the fresh air. And then you also have another balcony out here with a table and chairs that you can enjoy as well. So lots of, if it's not too hot and you don't need the air conditioning, you can open up and have a great tropical breeze. But lots of living space, very, very comfortable, and a fantastic new hotel here. 5-star, definitely 5-star. Brand new in Tahiti, and I think it is going to be a great success. So once again, this is Carl with Tahiti by Carl. Contact me to plan your trip to Tahiti. What I do is work with travelers to take the complexity out of booking customized, memorable Tahitian vacations. Thanks for watching, and join me again on some of my other videos. So there we have it. So it was interesting when I was watching that. I thought I should have counted how many different sliding doors I have in that room, right? There's 1, 2, 3. I think there's probably six different sets of sliding doors in that room. And you could see, I noticed in the video too, because we were talking about the private dining.
Yeah, I was noticing that as well. That's where the private dining room is.
Yeah, I see the private dining room there, the entire private dining room there too. So it's really quite nice. So Dana, I think, loved it as well. Thank you, Dana. Thank you for joining. Melissa. Oh, yes. That offers a larger balcony or terrace. I actually wrote that down when we were watching that, because I said the balconies aren't all that large, But you do have some that have the larger balconies and terraces, right?
We do, yes. We have a new category that's coming out. It's called Grand Balcony, which I'm going to send Carl a picture and he can share the picture of that. So it has a large terrace with two chaise lounges on it. Also, the two bedrooms have larger balconies because that wing was a new build, mm-hmm. that whole wing. And then the two royal presidential rooms, they have large balconies.
Balconies too.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if something like that, if anybody, you know, if we're working on planning your trip and you really want a larger balcony, you know, just make sure you mention that to me because then I can work to make sure that we get you booked into the right room category. Because as Jennifer just said, some of the room category names are changing, and this is very common. People don't realize it, but this is very common at resorts where they change the room names and the room categories. They could still be the same room, but so you might say, oh, I want this room, but what that room is this year, it might be called something different next year. So best be talking over to make sure you're getting what it is that you truly, you know, that you truly want on your trip. So that's good. I don't think, is there anything else you can think of that you wanted to add, Jennifer? Or
no, I just you know, we were talking earlier about the island of Tahiti and people really don't stay there.
Yeah.
They just stay for one or two nights and go off to other islands. But I experienced, I've been to Tahiti many, many times. And I'm embarrassed to say that the last time I went was the first time I actually ever went and explored the island. And it's absolutely beautiful. Mm. And you've seen more than I have. So,
There is a lot to see and do on the island. And a lot of people don't spend the time. Like you say, it's the one night pre and then maybe a day room at the end, which if you don't have the time, I understand. But for those of you that have time, if you're hikers, it has some of the best hiking. I've got hiking guides to do all kinds of hikes. I did an amazing hike. It was a little more than what I was expecting, but it was a hike through the lava tubes. And you've got all from the, you know, it's a volcanic island. And so you've got all these lava tubes. And so you go through three sets of lava tubes and each one gets progressively bigger and darker and a little bit colder. When they gave us a wetsuit, I was like, such a hot day. I'm like, I'm going to wear this wetsuit. And by the end, I'm like, put this wetsuit on. It's so cold. But you rappel in some places. You get into this lava tube that had like a waterfall inside the lava tube and you could climb up and you could jump off of it. And it's pitch, pitch black, but you've got your headlamps in there. So there's some real adventurous things. Of course, Tahiti has the surfing. You know, they're hosting the Olympics. You know, the next Summer Olympics, the surf competition is being held down in Chopu. So you know, it's good for surfers. We got the waterfalls like you saw on your tour, right? So lots of waterfalls to see. But yeah, there's a lot of different island tours. There's the history, you know, where Captain Cook landed at Point Venus. So many different things that we can do on the main island of Tahiti if you're interested, and just depending on how much time everybody has. But as you can see, when you look at this hotel, it's not a bad place to spend a little bit of extra time, right? So yeah, no, that's good. Thanks, Jennifer. I forgot I was going to, we talked about that. I totally forgot. So Liz just saying thanks.
Thanks for joining us.
Good. And I think that's all the questions for anybody who is watching regularly. Just a reminder that next week I am not doing any presentation. I'm off to a travel awards ceremony here in Toronto. So I won't be broadcasting live next week. But I'm really looking forward to June 29th. I have Richard Wan from Robert Wan Pearls who will be joining me to talk all about Tahitian pearls, which if you don't know, Tahiti is famous for their pearls. I'm sure Jennifer probably has some pearls. No?
Just a few.
I was thinking that look is no. It's like, okay, that look was like, yeah.
No, my husband hates it when I go because he's like, what's she going to bring home now?
Yeah, so, and the pearls aren't just for the girls. There are some places harder to find things for guys. But there are some, you know, you can get some really nice necklaces and bracelets and things like that for guys as well for the pearls. But I'm looking forward to having Richard on because it's just something that I haven't talked about yet. And Robert Juan pearls are a leader in the Tahitian pearl, you know, pearl industry there. And then I'm going to get Jennifer to come back again because we were talking about all the updates and changes of the Conrad Bora Bora. So we haven't picked a date for that yet, but we'll figure out when she's available to join me. To join me again, and we'll do some updates on the beautiful Conrad Bora Bora Nui, which I always say is one hotel. Every time I go, I feel like it's just gotten better. It just keeps on getting a little better, a little better, a little better, which is always, you know, always nice to see. So one quick last comment here. Sandra again. Is that June 29th or June? Oh, did I put the wrong date? It's the Thursday, Sandra. Whatever the Thursday is. Sorry, I don't have my calendar in front of me right now. Maybe I put the wrong date there. So whatever the Thursday is at 5 p.m. And of course, it'll be recorded I've been doing this for over a year. They're all recorded on the YouTube channel. So please as well, just a reminder, if you've enjoyed the presentation we did today, please give it a like on either Facebook or YouTube or Twitter, wherever it is that you're watching it. But give it a like for us. It makes a big difference for me with my business fighting the big Google algorithms and things like that. So I really appreciate it. And if you want to catch more of them, the best way to do it is on my YouTube channel, subscribe to my YouTube channel, you ring the little bell to get notifications, and it'll tell you when I'm going live. But everyone is always saved, and it's saved there on the YouTube channel, so you can dig back and watch tons of different presentations. But otherwise, I just want to say thank you, Jennifer. Really appreciate you.
Thank you for having me.
Joining me and taking the time, and thank you, everybody, for joining us again live. I really appreciate you pitching in and the comments and questions, and we will see everybody again in 2 weeks. All righty. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye now.